So subaortic stenosis is a congenital heart disease that we see really commonly in Newfoundlands. It's the most common heart disease that dogs are born with. And of the breeds that we see, Newfoundlands are really overrepresented for this disease. It is characterized by an abnormal ridge of tissue just below the aortic valve that causes severe heart disease in dogs, specifically Newfoundland dogs. So moderate or severe affected dogs with subaortic stenosis can have episodes of fainting or collapse associated with ventricular arrhythmias or cardiac arrhythmias. They can also go into congestive heart failure where they have difficulty breathing. Some dogs will display exercise intolerance with play activity, and other dogs won't show any signs, and unfortunately their first sign of disease is sudden death. To diagnose subaortic stenosis, it's first suspected based on the presence of a heart murmur at the level of the aorta. Confirmation of this disease relies upon ultrasound of the heart to measure the speed with which blood moves out of the aorta. Unfortunately, this disease is not very common in human beings either, and so we didn't have a really good starting place of genes to screen. There were a few that were proposed to interact in that area of the heart, but screening of those genes didn't identify any mutations. So we really had to take a whole genome or look at every chromosome in the dog genome type of approach to find the causative mutation for this disease. The genetic screening test is now available for this mutation that's associated with the disease. And so breeders can screen their pets for this mutation presence and know that breeding these dogs that have the mutation is a certain risk for development of disease.